Ladies and gentlemen, come gather around. Little known fun fact about turbochargers and boost. It'll push the oil right out of your engine. We're gonna fix that. Let's go!
Your engine, all engines, have piston rings to seal against the cylinder walls. There's compression rings to keep combustion in the top of the piston, and oil scraper rings to keep oil out of the combustion chamber. And in order for these to be installed, they have a gap. That's the only way you're going to make this work. There's a specification by your manufacturer on how big this gap should be. The point of the gap is so, well, partly so you can put them on the pistons, but they need to have a little bit of a gap and a certain amount so that when you're going up the steepest of hills, hauling the heaviest of friends with the biggest of payloads, going the highest of speeds, and everything heats up and expands, these things still don't touch. When these ring gaps touch, and they continue to expand, they will buckle and break the tops of your pistons off, so the gap needs to be specific. It's okay to be a little bit bigger, you're just going to leak a bit of combustion, you're just going to leak a little bit of oil. If you have a power adder like a supercharger or a turbocharger or a nitrous, you should get in there with a ring filer and grind these gaps bigger and bigger and bigger, so that with the added heat, they still don't touch. So, but all engines have gaps. And I've never seen an engine that I've taken apart have gaps that are acceptable. They always wear a little bit thinner. So when the engine's running, some of that combustion is going to get past these rings into the crankcase. That's just a fact of life. And that's kind of what we're dealing with right here. So this is my first setup on the ventilation system. And I use some dash 10 AN fittings. Quite enjoyable. I use a bit of electrical tape to figure out where to make the cut. 16th cutting disc, and then I use the AN fittings. One is already done. I just shove that in, make sure it's shoved all the way in. A little bit of oil, screw it all together. I poorly placed the camera in this shot, so wait, I'll show you another one later on. Here's the fitting. You want to have some kind of fitting like this. I thought this was genius. It actually sucked. This oil cap is designed, I think, for one pin or two pins, and it isn't on the valve cover, but whatever. The elbow, slight elbow that I made, I drilled a hole and I bought a dash 10 stainless AN bung that I could weld into this thing. And so this just positions the air filter just enough that I can actually close the hood on this truck. So it's all stainless. This is 4-inch from the stainless exhaust. Instead of back gassing, I'm using solar flux, which is a bit pricey, but definitely handy. And to clamp it all together, and we TIG weld it. I am not the best at TIG welding stainless, so if it looks less than satisfactory, it probably is, but I'm okay with that. Enjoying this welding helmet. It's like full color kind of stuff, and a really comfortable headband on it. It's quite enjoyable. I have two. This one I use for TIG, so it doesn't get quite so dirty. And then I have a dirty one I use for MIG welding. So with the elbow on there and all ready to go, clamped into place, I hook up the AN fitting. You should have pivoting elbows if you're doing that at all. If you don't have any pivoting elbow, you should have one straight end if you're using a fixed elbow. Eventually, I altered the factory oil fill cap because I thought the one I bought was kind of faulty. I was getting a lot of oil all over the place. Then I bought this catch can. It was the cheapest catch can, which I think is the smallest catch can. My idea behind it is I'm going to have bungs that go into the oil fill cap and one that goes up to the air filter, and then gravity can feed it back in. I have a theory behind this. I don't want to have a catch can that I need to continually drain, and I don't want it vented to atmosphere because I don't think that's right. So this is what I'm trying to do. The inside's a little interesting. I did buy some stainless kitchen scrubbies, which I might stuff in there as extra filter material, or I might make a second plate. I don't know. We'll see how it goes. But I TIG welded the one aluminum bung on the bottom of the catch can and disassembled it, cleaned up the surfaces, and then welded another one on the top. It does come with threaded fittings. Whatever, I'm just drilling it out. I ended up drilling this all the way in, cleaning up and making sure that it breathes fairly well inside. And this side was labeled out. I don't know if it's the out side. This might be all wrong, but I'm trying it. We're going to see how it goes. So, AN fitting welded to the top of it. I'm going to thread a plug
into the other hole, which used to be the inlet side. That's going to get plugged. And we're going to TIG weld this together. This is not my best TIG welded aluminum because I'm showing it to you. When I don't show you, I have beautiful welds. When I show you guys my welds, they're not beautiful. However, it holds, it does not leak. And it beautifully discolored the paint or anodizing or powder coating or whatever. It does come, this is the plug that went in the bottom of the catch can, which would normally be your drain. I don't show very well what's going on. I just threaded it into the inlet that's no longer being used as an inlet at all. Then I attach the whole catch can back together. And I have devised a way of mounting this somewhere. I'm going to spray it with a little bit of paint. Semi-gloss, I think. Whenever you finish off a can of spray paint, you should keep the tips. Blow them out with compressed air. Make sure they flow freely, just in case you get a plugged tip or something with a new can. So this is just a shelf elbow for hanging shelves. And I attached it to an existing screw. I may come up with something a little bit better. And a hose clamp to hold this in place. This is higher than the oil fill cap. And I'm going to make a couple AN fittings to drain the schmoo back into the crankcase. I'll explain why in a bit. I like electrical tape with a thin sliver of a silver line to show me where to cut. Eye protection and ear protection. And just reaching for a plug and we'll cut through this thing. I usually wear leather gloves when I'm using cutting discs. Somebody's skin to protect my skin. Then clean it off, and then I argued with this, because of course, it's on video, and I'm trying to show how to make these, and it's just not being quite as friendly as I'd like. Eventually, I just get medieval, and I shove the whole thing in. There is a company called Cool Tools, K-O-U-L, that make these thingies that help you do this job a whole lot easier. It works for me when I'm not worrying about how it looks for you. Make sure the hose is pushed all the way down into your AN fitting. And then I have soft jaws, a little dribble of oil in there, and then screw it all together. I did buy a set of aluminum AN wrenches, which I do not enjoy. It was not as much fun. Normally, and I will show you because I'm going to get irritated in a moment, I clamp a big, huge adjustable wrench in the vise and then use another big, huge adjustable wrench to tighten these up. If it bothers you to scratch your anodized fittings, don't do it this way. But there's a lot less colorful language when I just use ordinary wrenches. However, I bought these aluminum ones and I'm trying them out and I don't like them. In theory, it should not scratch the coatings like I care. So this is just a little short guide to go from the catch can to the oil fill, and then I'm going to quickly slice up the what was left of the existing hose, change the end, blah, 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 clip it on, clamp it on, tube it up, tup, and then we have the new end. I'm just reusing the hoses. I do like AN fittings. They are fun to put together, and they look racy. And then we'll put it all together. Give you a bit of a review.
Functionally, the system from the factory would work like this. There's a hose that goes from the back driver's side valve cover right into the intake manifold, which is under here. And anything that gets past the rings gets sucked into the motor through that back hose. And it's usually a metered orifice, a certain amount of controlled bleed of air that's going into there, so the engine kind of knows how much it's sucking into there. In order for the schmoo that gets past the rings to get sucked into the motor, there needs to be a feed for it. So over on the passenger side valve cover down here, this guy goes to the back of the passenger valve cover and gets sucked into the intake manifold. I've plugged this, so I cut it because I had a one-way check valve, but that wasn't working so well. So I've just got a plug in there. So this should go to this side of the throttle plate, so fresh filtered air comes in, goes through that little hose into that valve cover, goes past the rings, picks up all the schmoo, gets sucked in the intake manifold back there. Under full throttle, there's no vacuum sucking that in, but under full throttle, you're probably going to have a whole bunch of stuff going past the rings anyways. So now, instead of pressurizing the crankcase, it comes through that little hose and goes into the airstream and gets sucked in the motor and burnt. And so some folks put a catch can in that system. And in theory, you probably should have the catch can on this system, on this side, catching the debris that's going into the airstream. I probably wouldn't put one over on that side because when you're cruising, it really doesn't matter. Nevertheless, This is a turbocharged engine, and there things are a little bit different here. So instead of having the fresh air come from the clean side of the throttle into there, through there, to there, to there, to there, instead, I've still got that system. So the valve cover going in the intake manifold under vacuum. So when I'm cruising, it takes all the schmoo and burns it. Awesome. In order for that to work, instead of taking fresh air from here into the valve cover, instead, I've got my AN fitting threaded into the oil cap, which goes into here, to the catch can, to here. So fresh filtered air is gonna come through this line, go into there. This is irrelevant at the moment. For that fresh filtered air is gonna go into the valve cover at the oil cap, collect all the schmoo, and get sucked into the motor in the back, which is awesome. Under full throttle, and in this case, it'll probably be boost. Under boost, when this turbo is chooching, just wonderful, it's gonna pressurize all of this. And I don't want this to pressurize the crankcase through that hose. So I don't know if you can see that. There's a one-way check valve right here. So when boost is coming in, it seals it off. So it shuts off the air going into the crankcase here, thus trying to balloon the engine block, okay? So it seals that off. But all the stuff is gonna go past the rings, probably more because it's boosted. So what I do have is this line here. All that stuff is gonna come out of this big dash 10 AN fitting into this guy. There's going to be some oil in there because Chevy, thank you, you didn't baffle the oil fill. So oil has been coming out and polluting this, but now oil saturated air should come into here. This will separate the oil out of it. The air will continue this way and hopefully unoiled air will go into the turbo and get fed by the motor. Some would put a filter on here and just filter that to atmosphere, but I don't want it. I don't want debris, engine blow-by all over the engine compartment. I want to put it in here because this is the proper way of dealing with the pollutants from your rings, the blow-by. It needs to go back through the motor for the sake of the environment. Because this is fed up from the bottom, when you're off boost and things all relax again, fresh air is going to come back into here and take the oil and suck the oil back into the crankcase. And so that way I shouldn't have to empty that all the time. I shouldn't run low on oil. It should be okay.
And I know the hardcore guys are gonna go, oh, you don't want that stuff drained back into the engine. Pfft. It's like eating pizza with your mouth open and a hunk of pizza falls down out of your mouth onto the plate and you just like pick it up and put it back in your face. It came out of the crankcase. It can go back into the crankcase. And then the guys are gonna go, oh no, but that's like impurities and moisture and crap. It's like, that's what's in your engine anyways. You need to get the engine up to temperature to boil off all of that moisture at any rate. And what better way to draw it out of the engine than to have it get sucked back into the intake system? And I know you guys are like, oh, it's gonna cost you horsepower and everything. You know what? It doesn't. Because when you're cruising, this thing does its system and we get fresh air in and it cleans the schmoo out. And getting that stuff sucked out of the crankcase and out of the motor, not just venting it through a filter, but actually sucking it, moving it out of the crankcase, saves your motor oil, which saves your bearings and makes your engine last a whole lot longer. It does. You don't have to believe me. I can be boisterous and volatile, and then I get banned from forums. The PCV system, the positive crankcase system, is good for your engine, and under full throttle, it shuts off. Okay? So it doesn't even hurt you. Everything to gain. Oh, I'm gonna get like carbon all over my intake system. It's because your rings are shot. That's why. So fix the stupid motor and it works fine. So this should work okay. I'm gonna give it a go and see how that works. I did find out in servicing this that my one-way check valve back there was missing the spring. So it wasn't stopping stuff from going into the crankcase. Nevertheless, that's probably why I got a lot of oil out of there. Nevertheless, I have a new one with a new spring and we'll see if that works. Curious to see how that oil separator works for me. Who knows? But we'll see. Lots of opinion on the internet how this should and should not be done. This is set up strictly for a boost system. Some guys will put the catch can between the valve cover and the intake manifold to catch debris so it doesn't get sucked into your motor. I don't care that much. What I don't want is oil going, like massive amounts of oil being pushed into the intake system, into the turbo and all of that. And under a turbo engine, that's more of an issue. Nevertheless, I want to save the environment at least a little bit. We got to breathe that air. Sounds like a soapbox, political grandstand. Hey, vote Quimby. As always, thanks for watching, take care, and we will see you again.